In fact, yesterday I'm submitting a motion for emergency debate on this issue. Tetapi kita ada berasa tukar cita lah. The speaker has rejected my motion. The speaker in the letter stated, bilang saya telah meneliti perkara yang dipanggilkan oleh Yang Berhormat dan isu ini merupakan perkara yang serius. Speaker pun accept, pun agree ini satu perkara yang serius. Dan dia juga sudah justru pihak kerajaan telah berusaha dengan sebaik mungkin untuk membebaskan ketua-tua tubusan tersebut. Yes, kita faham. Kita tidak bukan sebut ini kerajaan tidak berusaha dengan baik selama ini dua orang yang dicuri. Tetapi yang masalah malangnya, only one of them is selamat. Satu yang beheaded. Jadi kita mau tahu ini satu yang in fact this is we want a special emergency to debate. Mengapa ini mulai berlaku? Mengapa satu yang diselamat and satu yang begitu strategi yang ada di tipu itu? And I understand pada masa yang last week yang selam itu Madam Ten yang diselamat dibalik di Sandakan, kita ada telefon dia. Dan juga kita pun semua pun suka hatilah Sandakan seluruh. Pada masa itu, the police is still giving a very, very confirmative message to the people that another orang yang penculik yang benar itu akan diselamat. Tetapi malangnya tragedi begitu berlaku. And then we feel very sad. That is important that we want to know in during the special session for debate. We want to know what is the next step, what is the government will do. At the present moment, kita tahu semua yang alat-alat yang dicanggih lah, sophisticated weapon, kita tidak ada. Kita tidak ada helikopter. Kita tidak ada satu yet. We have been mentioned many times macam the automatic identification system. Menjaga merantau to check all the shipment on the ship. Because at the present moment, it's already proven. Berapa tahun sudah, 4 tahun yang ditubuh oleh ini ESKOM, it don't give us the security. Kidnapping one after another happen. We have been on defensive for so many years. Defensive, only kita jaga, kita kufil, kita sebagai mana. Tapi ini tidak menjamin kita punya keselamatan. So I think the government should be take note that we should be more offensive. We also hope our Perdana Menteri can bring up this issue. Walaupun kemarin yang what to call our Menteri Luar Negeri ada support ini juga to make it a very strong stand. Jadi seluruh di sini, we want to be more offensive. We have to take military stand to hapus ini satu pengganas yang mengancam kita keselamatan khasnya di Sabah.
I would like to express our deepest condolence to the family of the beheaded kidnapped victim, and also our great disappointment on the way government is handling this. The government is failing to protect our own citizen in our own shore. All right, I think that's why we move a motion. The motion Sandakan move a motion of emergency, and I do not agree with the speaker's decision that this is under the jurisdiction of foreign ministry, and the foreign ministry has replied in the committee stage of the budget debate, and therefore the matter is over. I think the foreign ministry deal with government to government, G to G. Right, what we are talking here is the government of Malaysia against the terrorists. So you have no representative of the terrorists for your foreign ministry to deal with. I think this matter goes beyond the foreign ministry jurisdiction. It falls under the security, that is internal affairs ministry. It falls under the navy, that is pertahanan. So, and also the ESKOM is under the JPM. So it falls under different ministry. All right, so for a single ministry to answer this question and treat the matter as already done with, I think that is totally absurd.